G'day Toronto, how are you? It is so nice to be here. Thank you for having us. It's been over 8 years, I think, since we've played together in Toronto. So way too long. We're going to play a whole bunch of different songs from the new record and from all the records we've made over the last 20 years. So it's going to be a bit of a journey. That song we just played is a song called Losing You from a record we put out a few weeks ago called Cake for a Steer. Thank you. And now we're going to play an old song, which is from a record we made maybe 12, 13 years ago called Down the Way. It's one of my favorite songs that Angus has written, and I love this song so much. On my birthday a few years ago, I asked Angus if he would write the name of the song on my foot, and then I went to the tattoo parlor and got it. You can't see it from there, but it's there. Anyway, I love this song, and I'm very happy to have these words written on my foot. Yellow Brick Road. There'll be sunshine.
Ricky.
This is a song about loving somebody just the way that they are. This was written in the north of New South Wales about somebody fantastic.
So if my little sister hassles me enough to play a song, eventually I've got to do it.
I've been asking Angus to play this song for not one word of a lie, about 15 years. And I used to ask him every night before the show, can we play this song? And he would say, no. And then I'd ask him again and he would say, no. But then I asked him tonight and I said, can we play this song?
I said, fuck it, we're in Toronto, let's give it a call. Sometimes songs just aren't ready to take on a life of their own, and I never really wanted to play the song, I feel like it comes a time where it's time to let it shine. It's a song called Just a Boy.
Smile.
Hey, thank you for that.
When we were growing up, and to this day, our dad is a wedding singer, so he's always been playing around at parties and weddings in our local community. And it was really cool growing up with his band rehearsing in the house, because they were playing all of these amazing songs, and we just thought, like, Dad was so incredible writing all this music. We didn't really understand the concept of a cover band. So, yeah, it was kind of a nice illusion to live under till we were probably about 9 or something.
Yeah, we thought Dad was John Lennon, Bob Dylan, here we are.
Creedence Clearwater.
Taylor Swift.
It's been a confusing time, but we got to this point where, you know, you're old enough to be going to friends' houses and they're playing, you know, Imagine, and you're kind of like, how'd you get Dad's record? So we figured out he was a liar. No, but seriously, it was a really lovely experience and really good for us to be surrounded by all of that stuff and all of those songs. And it also instilled in us a real love of interpreting and covering music. And to this day, it's something that we absolutely love to do. And so we're going to play our most recent favorite song to cover. And it's sort of a little bit of a thank you to our dad for lying to us. No, it's a thank you to him, because the song also is a little bit, the lyrics remind us of him, because he's such an independent person and really, he just is very happy in his own company, much to the disappointment of his many wives. Anyway, hopefully no one was filming that. Don't put it on the internet! Anyway, it's a song by Miley Cyrus. It's called Flowers.
We thought Dad was Miley Cyrus for a long time. So, yeah,
do you
want to
whistle?
Sure.
Okay, one, two, three.
paint my nails cherry red, just like the roses that you left. No, no remorse, I have no regrets. I forgive every word that you said. I didn't want to leave you, but I didn't want to lie. I started to cry, then remembered that I can buy myself flowers, buy my name in the shadow. Talk to myself for hours, saying things you don't understand. I can take myself dancing, I can hold my own hand, I can love me.
Okay, so we got asked from someone in the audience to play the song tonight. So, give it a crack.
You come down to the clouds, feeling like a fool. I ain't got nothing left to give, nothing to lose.
The only world.
The only world.
The only world.
day, it's happy today, wouldn't say it. Here on my throne. Oh, song, come on, love, dry your soul. Thank you.
We're gonna go way back to our very, very first EP. This was made 20 years ago in our living room at home, and it was sort of, we just started writing songs. Angus had been writing songs for a few years actually, and I just started writing songs. And we got some friends around who knew how to set up microphones, and we played these six songs, and that made this EP called Chocolates and Cigarettes. And that EP took us on this wild adventure. It started everything off, and about 6 months after we made it, we moved to London with our first record deal. And we really didn't know what we were doing.
We still don't know what we're doing.
That's true. That is true. But we like to not know what's going to happen, and this song was one of those songs that just is so weird and wonderful. It's a song that's going to feature the incredible banjo playing by Mr. Benjamin Edgar, so look out for it. Yeah, it's a song called Private Lawns.
Thank you.
Benny Edgar.
That's Julia Stone on the trumpet. Like Julia was saying, you know, we kicked off when we were kids, just figuring it out in the living room, and we found some microphones and recorded ourselves. And it's still the same. You know, Julia flies up to where I live, up on the northeast of Australia, and we never really know what's going to happen, and sometimes it just takes that one song to kick it all off and to start the conversation of another record, and this was that song called Cape Forestier.
Be right.
You know, I feel so lucky to be able to wander the earth and share music with this beautiful human next to me. I'm inspired by the way she is as a human, and the way she moves through the world, and you know, with the chaos going on at the moment and in general. It's really cool to be around someone that sees light and hope in the way she does. And her songwriting, it's cool. You know, I'm a big admirer of the way she puts imagery in with her music. And a lot of Australians, I don't know if there's any Australians here, but yeah, I don't know if you guys grew up with it, but there's a film called Candy, and it's got Heath Ledger and Abbie Cornish, and it's a really beautiful film. It's a tragic love story, but yeah, Julia pulls some imagery out of that. She references a scene. I don't know, I'm just a big fan of this song, and I feel so lucky to be playing with you. You're a good egg.
Thank you.
So anyways, this is a song called Wherever You Are by a lovely Joyous Night. You want me to start it?
Yeah, you start it. We made called A Book Like This. So it's a song when we were teenagers. We lost a friend of ours. She was too young. But this is how we remember her. It's a song called Bella.
Built us a flying machine. we'll go we want. We'll sail, sail on seas. I hope all is well in Daisy's dream.
Thank you.
Yeah, this song we wrote for a friend of ours that got married about 12 years ago. Unfortunately, they're divorced now. So it was called the wedding song, but now it's sort of the divorce song. they're both fine, but. It's a song that has taken its own sort of journey. We've played it at a few friends' weddings now, and we've also played it at our mum's wedding. She got married to our stepdad, and we sang this song for her. And it also became a song that other people who probably have successful marriages have got married to, and they sent us footage of their weddings from all over the world, and so we have this beautiful video we got sent so many videos from every corner of the globe, people celebrating love. It was so special. We watched a lot of wedding videos.
Yeah, there was like big Bollywood where they're all dancing down the to the backyards of Australia, to Africa, to Amsterdam, the Belgium.
Yeah, we got a couple from Toronto as well.
Some from Toronto.
Is it anyone from the video here tonight? No. They're probably away on their honeymoon or something. Anyway, this is a song that has been really nice to re-record and make a kind of a nicer version. It was kind of an original. Originally, a live version was being used, and it was pretty bad.
If you need us for a wedding, by the way.
They are available.
We also do funerals. If you're getting divorced, we'll stand with you in the court whilst you sign the papers.
In the moon. gonna build a home together. You and I forever and ever and we'll make babies on the beach under the stardust. And I will hear your voice come to the door a thousand times, maybe more. I smile inside to know you're mine.
Yeah, we're trying to play at least two songs from every record, or at least one. And this next one.
This is like the forgotten record.
It's the forgotten record. No one gave a shit about.
I know, we love it.
It's probably Julian. It's my favorite record.
Yeah, it's my favorite record too. But...
And no one listened to it. So thanks for that. We got approached by a company in Colorado that made video games, and one of the video games, one of the video games is that they were making is called Life is Strange, and it's cool. I mean, I play games. I'm a completionist. I have to finish things, but. When you go into story mode and it goes off into the movie when you're playing the game, they're called Zen Moments. So they would send us the storyboard of the Zen Moments. Anyways, there was a love scene in the game and we wrote this song to it.
Baby got a love song.
Thank you.
What was that? I didn't hear. We're gonna play a song that I wrote to try and get an ex-boyfriend back. It didn't work.
What's the song called?
Oh, this song's called For You. I know, I mean, it's like crazy that I sent this song to him and it was like, you're never gonna have to go to work. You can be a star in the universe. Anyway, he still said no. he actually sent me back a song that he had written. And I was excited when I opened up the email, because he said, oh, I've also written a song. And I think he just thought I was sharing songs, you know, I hope. But anyway, he sent me a song called Going to Hell. Angus just said, I am going to hell.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming out and being with us tonight. It's a real, how do I say this? I guess it's just like mind-blowing to us that we started doing this and it ended up being here tonight in Toronto with all of you guys. So thank you for making it possible. None of this would happen without our incredible crew. If you can please join us in thanking Adam on front of house, Gordo on lights, Freddie TMing, we've got Will over here on in-ears, Christy on guitars. There's so many people that that actually get us here, and of course, there's these incredible musicians on stage with us tonight that I would love to introduce you to. So, this incredible woman is joining us from Auckland, New Zealand. She's on the bass guitar and vocals. Please put your hands together for Miss Casper. Behind us, keeping the beat and singing beautifully, Miss Lauren Benson. And this man, he makes it sound like there's 15 of him on stage. He's playing nylon string guitar, banjo, electric guitar, lap steel, and piano, and singing beautifully. Please put your hands together for Mr. Benson. If it wasn't for the man sitting next to me. He taught me how to play the guitar, and then he was one of the first people who encouraged me to sing songs in front of people. He's a really dear friend, and I'm lucky to have been born into a family with him as my brother. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Angus Stone. Thank you.
Thank you so much. You know, it's really cool. We get to travel the earth and meet beautiful crowds like yourself tonight, Toronto. I guess the cool thing about it is we get to meet really, really beautiful people and have wonderful experiences. On the flip side, you have to say goodbye to special people. And I guess this song I wrote about not wanting to say goodbye and to take that person away with me. This is a song called Big Jet Plane. Well, thank you so much for having us. It's been very cool. Yeah. gonna sing this last part.
So how about we sing with you for a chorus? Yeah? All right.